Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is me Vidya from Millennial Mommyhood, and in my today's video we are going to talk about schemas. Have you ever seen your child going through a particular phase where the child is super interested in throwing around things? The child is super interested in hiding things around something. You don't find your remote, you don't find your mobile phones because everything will be hidden by the child somewhere under a pillow or under a cushion or maybe under a sofa or a blanket. You would have seen your child just enjoying twirling around a lot. You would have seen your child lining up everything in a straight line or something like that, and you will see your child repeating this particular behavior over and over again over a period of time. Well, if you have noticed that, then this is something which is known as schema, and in this video let us discuss about what schema is all about, what are the different kinds of schema. And in my coming videos, I will also tell you that how these schemas can be developed and how you can help your child to develop through this schema by providing them different kinds of activities which can be easily set at home. You don't need to buy any toys, you don't need to invest anything, you just need just random things which are available in your house, just random activities which just takes hardly 1 minute to make your child develop, especially when he's going through that particular schema. So keep watching. A very common question that everybody asks is to how to identify whether a child is going through a particular schema. Now, it is very easy. All you need to do is take a step back and observe when your child is playing. Observe throughout the day and observe what your child is doing, what your child is interested in, what are the things which he keeps on repeating over and over again. And when you start observing, you'll be able to easily categorize that which particular schema your child is going through. And then after that, once you know that what is a particular schema that the child is going through, you can follow whatever is related to that particular schema. You can give the activities related to that, or maybe you can even understand why the child is behaving in a certain manner if you understand that the child is actually going through that particular schema. When does the schema starts? They start anywhere from 18 months to up to 5 years, 6 years, and these are the changes you can see in every child all around the world. No matter where the child is, no matter how the child is, the children go through these schemas, and just by pure observation, just like how I told you previously, it is very easy to categorize which particular schema your child is going through. So schemas are actually these repeated behavioral patterns which a child follow, through which the child learns and explores everything that is around him. Now, if someone thinks that why is it important for a parent to understand which schema your child is actually going through? Now, imagine that you have utmost interest towards cooking, and at the same time, somebody's coming and telling you that, hey, you're not supposed to cook. Instead, I'm going to teach you how to swim. So this particular thing will not have a lot of interest, and you'll be kind of forced to learn something which you don't want to. Your heart lies towards cooking and you're ready to learn that, but you're being taught something which you're not ready for, or which you are basically not ready to explore about. So schemas are something similar like this. So when a child is going through a particular schema, the child is exploring everything around that particular thing. So what happens is that if you are providing more and more opportunities for the child to explore more and more in that particular schema, in that particular behavioral pattern, then it becomes much more easier. Now, how does it help? It increases the engagement time of the child. The child sits with the activity for a longer period, the child enjoys the activity for a longer period, and you are providing more and more scope for your child to explore on that particular thing. So it is always very important to understand that which schema your child is currently going through. Now, what are the activities that you can provide for a child when a child is going through a particular schema, and you identify that? Now, once you identify which schema your child is going through, the first and the most important thing is to understand that what is the thing that the child loves in that particular schema. For example, if I am talking about connecting schema, that is something where the child loves to connect things. So you have to understand that what are the activities that I can give to him where there is more of connecting activity. So when you give him more of connecting activity, since he's already into it, he will be more glued to it and he will love to do those activities, and he keep on exploring different kinds of thing in the same. So activities can be anything. you get toys, different kinds of toys, but we all know that toys can only serve one single purpose. You buy a toy, if it's a connecting toy, it can be used as a connecting toy, but cannot be used for something else. So instead of resorting to toys or buying something like that to support your child's schema, you can just look around your house and you can think that what are the things that needs to be connected. So if your child is going through a connecting schema, give the things which can be connected, which can be joined together, or something which the child enjoys. Now I'll be giving a whole detail of all these kinds of schemas and how to develop that, what are the activities that you can do for this in my upcoming video. And trust me, I'm just going to give everything in detail. I'm not going to suggest you any kind of toys, but at the same time, if I feel that something is worth it, I will definitely suggest that to you people so that you can also try it out. But otherwise, just the random things in the house, the random activities around the house is more than enough to support your child's schema. But if you understand, as I always say, the most important thing is to observe your child. Only when you observe your child is when you will be able to understand which particular schema your child is actually going through. So till my next video, which I'll be posting in a couple of days, make sure you start observing your child. You start observing that what is a pattern behavior, what is a behavior that he keeps on repeating again and again. Does he keep on throwing things over and over again, and does he enjoy that? Does he keep hiding things under the pillow over and over again, and does he enjoy that? So keep a tab on your eyes, on your child, keep a watch on your child, and just without interrupting, basically that's what we call about uninterrupted play. Give them uninterrupted play, watch them and watch them closely and understand what are the things that actually interest them and what are the things that they keep on repeating over and over again without getting bored. So next time when I'm talking about the different kinds of schema, it'd be very easy for you to place your child in a particular schema or two and understand that your child is actually going through this particular thing. So if you like this video, please do not forget to like, and if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel. It's going to help me out a lot. Until next video, this is Vidya. Bye bye.